So, let's start with episode 9. It's been a while. But I want to get done with this fucking game so I can start other games. Alright, let's go.
So, you want the Nazis to leave the warhead alone once you planted it, right? Well, what you gotta do is place it in the Oberkommando's nuclear reactor. That way the Nazis won't be able to track its radiation signature. They won't find it, they won't disarm it.
At this point, I've pretty much fucking got all my perks.
That must be the dot you should save keep Seth was talking about.
Thank you.
fucking tick.
Are you fucking kidding me?
Blossom.
You see that?
Did you see that? Boom, boom, boom. Disaster.
So, you want the Nazis to leave the warhead alone once you planted it, right? Well, what you gotta do is place it in the Oberkommando's nuclear reactor. That way, the Nazis won't be able to track its radiation signature. They won't find it, they won't disarm it.
Safe keep set was talking about.
I am arming the warhead now. You may want to bug out of Roswell before this thing goes boom.
Far out, brother. Far out. I have my guy at City Hall sound the tornado alarm. Evacuate the whole town. Look for an exit and get the hell out of the blast zone. I'm almost done clearing out mission control. Meet you at the rendezvous by Galveston.
Done deal.
It's a new gun? Oh, yeah. What the fuck? Did you fucking throw it at the door? Oh, you bitch. Take it. But bitch. I need to have the gun. Awesome. Shit. beep, beep, beep. Oh shit, I wanna fucking...
me too, but my daddy says I'm not supposed to play with you. Why he say that? My daddy said that Negroes are a sickness on the community and a bad influence, dirty and thieves, and beggars and bums, and they don't know how to read or write, and that they're stinky and stupid and lazy and way too lazy to work an honest job.
Well, my daddy did, but my mama say white folks is mean as all get out, and hating and resenting on account they used to keep all colors as slaves, and now they're not allowed no more. And that's why I can't use a good restroom at the fair, and the man in the store won't let me in so I can buy chewing gum or soda pop.
What kind of chewing gum you like?
Injun Scout.
Red or yellow?
Yellow.
I hate the red ones.
The red ones taste like puke.
Yeah.
What you got in that jar, Billy?
Oh, it's nothing at all. It's for catching tadpoles.
What you gonna do with tadpoles in that jar?
Just go watch them swim. I feed them crumbs and carrots from the yard. Then they become pinky frogs.
Well, I've seen tadpoles down the stream. Follow me and I'll show you.
Okay.
Don't tell me that's
Come on.
The black girl that he's always in his daddy's school. The one that's helping him with the afro.
Afro, you show me the red ones. For when I met someone special. Well, I did. And then a look right on her finger.
What is this?
Look at this, Billy. Look, the rat fell in the mop bucket. Now he can't get out. Look at that.
He'll drown.
Probably.
He's saving Billy. He's drowning.
It's just a rat. He's gross. Eating our food and spreading germs, pooping in our cupboards.
He's dying! He's dying, Billy!
We got two options. Either I pay good money for a new parking lot, or you go down the well.
There somewhere, Billy.
Inclined
to this day.
Jesus.
To endure amongst the living.
Hey, you're too loud for my TV, you dick. Is there anything around the TV?
Goddamn ruckus.
Andy and Howie,
They pinned me down. They took my pocket knife.
What the hell is wrong with you? You let them take your property? They're gonna walk all over you till there's nothing left. Now, I gave you that pocket knife. It was in your care. It's your responsibility.
I respect your words.
You will do no such thing, Sophia. Oh, you're gonna let your mommy fight your battles for you, are you, boy? Now, you go on out there and take back what's yours, and you are not setting foot in this house again until you do.
Yep, that's what happens. Shit, fuck you. Am I ready for the basement, or should I go upstairs?
I'll be in the grave rotting away, and still a better daddy than you.
Should I do it? That. Larry Johnson.
Hey. Son, I have tried reasoning with you. I've tried smacking sense into you till the cows come home, and nothing is working. Every night you wake me up with these noises. No matter how many times I try to tell you there are no monsters in our basement.
Sorry, Daddy. At night, I see them. Clear as daylight. I'm coming to kill Mama.
All right. Here's what we're going to do. You take this.
Wow.
You and I are going down into the basement. And any monsters that show up, we shoot them dead right between their eyes. Sometimes the best way to fix a problem is to face it head on. You with me?
Yes, Daddy.
Sophia! You in on this? You see him?
No, Daddy. The monsters are gone.
Well, I reckon if you do no wrong, ain't no monster gonna come after you, son. You think we scared him off for good this time?
May I keep the gun?
Kid would have fucking blown his head off. Sleeping with a gun facing him. Stupid. Or him. Beachy Postum Dicks, whatever his name.
Place is gone as shit.
I ain't been down here in nearly a decade. I own a 2,000-acre ranch up by Forney Lake now. I heard on the radio you've been sighted up near Roswell. I figured you might show up here.
What the fuck?
Running in this house with bad memories.
So why'd you come? Need a place to hide. You need money. You're barking up the wrong tree, son. Far too late to come begging now.
Ain't nothing you can offer to make up for what you've done to us. I think of my father, I see. Fuck you and a fist flying in my face.
When'd you ever do right by me? Disobedient? Ungrateful, sense like a flat tire, and a mouth like a sewer. Oh, I saw where you was headed. I've been down that hole myself. And I guarantee goddamn to you, I did all in my might to pull you out. What more do you want from me?
I wanted you to treat me like I mattered. Like I wasn't some piece of dog shit got stuck on your shoe.
I did my damnedest with you. The truth is, you were broke beyond fixing. What are you, some sort of super killer terror bomber now? You're on the wrong side, buddy. All them years, I was banging my head into the wall, coming to see that everyone was against me. And when the Nazis took over, things got a lot better. You play by their rules, you can do very well for yourself. Ask anyone around these parts. Blaskowitz is a name of renown and respect. Everything you touch turns to shit, and I do not need your stink on my name. Wanted murderer. Run off to the army as soon as you come of age. Broke your mother's heart.
Where is she?
She's gone.
What happened?
What happened is we had a big goddamn war, and now we got a new government with new rules. They took her. She's gone. And what's that queer outfit you're wearing?
What do you mean they took her?
They rounded up all the Jews and the coloreds and the queers. This is a white man's world now. White man's got to keep it Christian.
You sold her out.
So what? Wife made a living bemoaning me and raised a boy into a murderer. I always saw you for what you are. 10 pounds of shit in a 5-pound bag. On your knees.
Daddy, I'm your son.
Down on your fucking knees.
Was a time I was scared of you. Was a time I'd have pissed myself, had a gun pointed at my head. You know what I feel right now? Not a goddamn thing.
Kick his ass!
No, not my problem, it stays on.
Oh, Christ! Will you just give us some privacy, please?
look like ass, man. Fuck. Looks like you're at death's door. Seriously, this is not a good look for you. Anyway, listen, your trial's coming up in a couple of weeks, and after that, they're gonna execute you, and that whole charade's gonna be televised to every living room on the planet. So instead of that bullshit going down, we're gonna break you the fuck out of here right now. It's kind of a risky plan, but the security they have around you is out of this world, so it's kind of the only play we got, right? I mean,
the hoops.
I had to jump through to get to you, and I'm your fucking lawyer. That pissed me off. Hey, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna make like you attacked me, and when the guard pig comes in looking for your ass, I'm gonna sneak up behind him, and I'm gonna shove this little number right in the base of his skull. I'm gonna grab his keys and his gun, and I'm gonna roll you right on out to the elevator. Popping Nazis wherever they show up, straight down the garage, where Bombati and Anya and everyone else has the getaway car. Okay, you ready? Let's get this freak show on the road.
Fucking idiot.
Fuck! That hurts so bad!
You don't even know! Let's get this fucking gag thing off you! Alright. Once we hit the street, it's all car chases and flying bullets. They got tanks outside, man. We got some tricks up our sleeve, though. We make it that far. We make it.
The hard part
is getting down to the garage.
Hey! Help! Help! Open the door!
He fucking attacked me, man! He broke my nose, and then he got out through that door right there! Look at Terror Billy! He's on the loose!
Stay back!
And he had help! They came and ran through that door, and they broke him out! It was space aliens, man!
Schnitt! Gott! Zimmermann! Sie haben Talent! Sie sollten zum Film gehen, bei Helene vorsprechen!
Guter Schuss, General! Der zuckt noch!
Idiot! He was dead as soon as he walked into the building. Tapferer, kleiner Liebling, ich bin dein und du bist mein Liebling, so lieblich. Und open your mouth. Open. That's it. How does it taste? Down there now and join in on the fun.
Anya, my family.
Weeks pass.
Or more.
Feel myself slipping away.
Let me pray
for the end.
For theft and destruction of public and private property. Aiding the enemy.
Torture.
Terrorism, including nuclear, both domestic and abroad.
And
high treason. For gruesome murders that number in the thousands, you have been found guilty, Mr. William Joseph Blaskowitz. It is rare, even for a man of my job description, to come face to face with true evil. And it pains me that the maximum sentence that I can bestow upon you is something as trivial as death.
Death,
Mr. Blaskowitz! Nothing but swift, sheer death! bailiff.
Well, I'm gonna end it there. See you guys on the next one. Bye.